And coming up next, we have Timmy Alexis Carrington Ward with Here She Is.
Pedantic people.
All right, Mr. Ward, final question.
What makes you think you'll be suited for this job?
Well, it's the dress code, isn't it? Wear a suit, then.
Hello, is it?
Hi, Timmy. It's Sam Bailey.
Well, I know a Sam Fox. She's an old common pop star and all. I said it. Anyway, how do I know you?
Don't you remember? I came to your restaurant that time.
Oh, hi there. How can I help?
Hi, I have a reservation under the name of Sam Bailey.
Okay, 1 minute. Tiny bit early. Would you mind waiting for a bit?
No, that's fine.
Brilliant. Well, you need this. Table 7 need their dessert. And table 10 want their bill. Okay, off you go.
You know, everybody was so excited to be at our autopsy club this evening. It was open mic night.
Hello and welcome to the Here She Is Entertainment News.
Julia Roberts caused controversy this morning when the press thought that she had come out. But apparently she had said she is a thespian.
A Hollywood insider has said that they're finally making a Disney movie about aromatic herbs. She was later heard to say, it's about time.
There's concern for Tom Cruise, who is going to be taking over the part of Pennywise in the new It movie. He's got big shoes to fill.
It's being said that the new Tetris movie is terrible. Each actor says four lines and then completely disappears.
And that's the end of our news tonight. So it's good night from me.
And it's good night from her.
Good night.
Welcome to my bed. Sam Bailey!
Thank you!
Now listen, before we start, do you want a drink?
I'd love one.
Hang on, wait there. There we go, cheers!
Wow! Thank you!
Now, before we start, I want to to address the elephant in the room.
Okay.
How are you?
I'm all right.
Perfectly harmless remark.
Where did your talent for singing come from?
I don't know. I just started singing when I was about 14.
Nobody in the family?
My granddad used to sing. He used to be called the singing window cleaner.
Was he a window cleaner?
Yes, he was.
That's funny handy enough. Then, isn't it? When I'm cleaning windows. You were a prison guard officer, weren't you?
When you hear your names, come forward.
Well, before I got onto the X Factor, I was a prison officer, yeah.
You know what? My husband actually calls me parole.
Does he?
Yeah, because I never let him finish his sentence. I said it.
Done anything?
Shut up.
I went to Birmingham prison.
How long were you in for?
I shouldn't be here. I haven't done anything.
So then we get to you going in the prison.
Yeah.
Are you not just literally a bit... Oh my God, I need a tenor lady.
I was crapping it, yeah.
I want my mummy!
Because when you first walk in, they see fresh meat.
Yeah, that's what I'm seeing now. Although I think it's past its sell-by date. Yeah.
Cheeky piece!
You went up for X Factor, didn't you, once before?
And yes, they said, I did.
No, thank you.
Yeah, they did.
No.
So, sort of in X Factor, you were a second-time offender, weren't you?
I just want to do my time and get straight.
Before that, were you
I was a blue coat in the late 90s.
Katie, hi!
I did cruise ships early 2000s.
You're going to need a bigger boat.
And wasn't there controversy that you had done that before you went on X Factor, being a professional?
Yeah, some people see that as a professional, but people see the stigma attached of cruise ship singer.
I saw you, because I was on one of those, and I didn't count that as professional.
I'm afraid I have to agree with that.
What then made you go onto X Factor?
There was a singer that was on the circuit, like me, and she had... Her name, I can't remember what her name was, just say her name was Lisa Lee.
Oh, I love Lisa Lee.
Lisa Lee,
yeah,
lovely.
I'm going to see her next week.
Are you?
She's so good.
So better than me.
She's, well, who isn't? Yeah.
Everyone knows that you're nothing but a second-rate lounge act.
And then she's got brackets at the end of her name on her poster that says, as seen on X Factor. And I know full well she was getting an extra 50 quid.
Right.
So I figured if I go on the X Factor and be like a blink and you'll miss me kind of vibe,
it still
I'll get me extra 50 quid a gig.
Money makes the world go around.
But I did win, and I did ended up getting not only a new kitchen, but a new kid, a downstairs toilet.
They could give you loads of things.
I know.
X Factor. I've won a kid.
Oh, can they do well?
So when you went away after the first time, did you think, well, I'm never going to do that again?
I just don't think, I'm going to feed you this now, but I don't think in 2007 I was interested enough. And off he goes.
What's that thing?
That's all.
And then, so what happened? So then suddenly you thought, I'm better.
The time I did it the second time round, I was a prison officer. And at this time I had a couple of kids. You know, I was...
Do you think it's a lot?
It's a lot.
A lot more to do with your backstory.
Yeah, it's a TV show before it's a talent competition. Yeah. And
well, that's how I saw it and all. I said it.
I was a joke act.
You were the joker.
What?
I am feeding him all these things. It's
someone's
like...
Someone's feeding you, by the looks of things.
Did the word diet ever enter your cerebellum?
Who were your judges?
Gary Barlow, Louis Walsh, Sharon Osbourne and Nicole Scherzinger. And when I went in for my audition and it went that well, that was when I had my own film crew that were filming me.
Rather fussing to be filming as one's working.
They mic'd me up and sat me down as if I was waiting to be interviewed, audition again, when I'd already done it. And then they got me outside and filmed me walking in. So I knew then, I'm going to get my extra 50 quid.
50 quid. Money. When do you know you're on the proper
program? Oh, it was weeks before I'd even got a call after that. And then it was like, right, this is the date. And then I had to go to the governor again.
Your action was underhand and highly improper.
Governor,
Don't interrupt.
Were they all right with it?
Up to that stage, they were. But then when I found out I got onto the actual live shows, I had to contact them and take... I needed a... What was it called?
A voice trainer.
A dietitian.
A magician. You're in over 25.
Yeah.
Is that cruel that they judged that on weight?
This is sport for...
for me.
I was a size 18 when I first went on that show. By the time I won, I was a size 12.
Was that nerves or you nerves. Started diet?
No, I didn't diet. Come on, the show was sponsored by Mr. Kipling.
That's what attracted you.
But then Mr. Kipling always does make exceedingly good cakes.
You're on in the over 25 category, yeah. So that means you're with Sharon Osbourne.
Yeah.
You had to go out to her house in LA.
I did, yeah. It was amazing.
Was that amazing?
Yeah.
Were you blown over first class?
No.
Or cattle class?
We were in cattle, but they filmed us in first class so that it looked like
so
we was in.
Naughty. Yeah. Tell me about your singing. You're so good, you have to act when you sing, don't you? Because it's so easy for you.
Singing for me is, I can just open my gob and sing.
What's your gob?
But I was kind of told by someone many, many years ago that if you want a massive standing ovation from people and you want people to be like, oh my gosh, you've got to make it look difficult because that's where you're going to grab the audience attention. So I sort of make myself look a bit constipated. In order, so that the veins kind of pop in my head. So you can see veins, I've got like a Y vein that comes here, that is the shape of a Y.
And it's funny because every time I do see you sing, I always think of shit.
Don't make it.
You've won X Factor.
Mm-hmm.
Was that when you released your, it was Skyscraper?
Skyscraper got to number one, went platinum.
I listened to Skyscraper.
Yeah.
Afterwards, I thought it was like the lift had broken down and I had to walk the stairs. That's how I felt after it.
You bastard.
I've got to support Beyonce as well.
You've got to support her.
I did.
But apparently you were meant to do 10, but only ended up as one.
Yeah, I only did one show.
Did she see how you performed?
I mean, she obviously saw me and thought, oh, she's fat. We won't put her on.
Well, she could have had you as a backdrop. Did you meet Beyonce?
No. I wasn't too fussed about meeting her. I would have just liked to have had like a signed t-shirt or something I could put in a frame and say, thanks for being my support artist. She didn't even have to write it.
We don't like
it. It could have been someone that, one of her minions.
We don't like her, do we?
No, I don't even think she probably, this is the thing about me and fame. I never wanted to get that famous that you had people.
I've seen your act.
I walked into that one, didn't I?
Oh, I said that to my husband last night.
Tramp.
So, for her, she probably didn't even know I existed.
Who is she? Who is she?
Then did jazz yourself up a bit after you became famous, didn't you? You had your teeth done.
Yeah, had my teeth done.
Good job, because before they
it
were
was
so...
awful.
You could have flossed with a sock.
Mind the gap.
I think you are salt of the earth. I do believe that you haven't, I don't think you have changed. I think you're grounded.
No, when you've got a little bit of money, you can go to nice places.
When you have got a bit of money as well, you can go to hairdressers as well and beauticians.
I suppose looks aren't everything.
You put on your Twitter that you're parting with your record company.
No, let's just change that. I got dropped by the record label.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
That's fine. That was my next question. Is that how it worked?
They just didn't see anywhere. I mean, they did their time. I don't think they particularly wanted to invest in me because, you know, all they see is a woman that's pregnant and three kids and
that auto-tuning, you know, takes
and
so
lots
long,
of auto-tuning.
It?
Let
it
me just point that out.
So
I've never
long.
Been auto-tuned in my life.
No, you should have been.
I should have been. Thank you.
What was your first musical you went into?
Chicago.
Because you played Mama Morton.
I did.
Yeah, and I bet that is not the first time you've been offered a female juicy part in prison.
Any port in the storm.
And then you carried on in the same vein. You got Fat Friends, didn't you?
I did Fat Friends.
Did your friend, Sharon Osbourne, recommend you to be in Fat Friends?
Because
you were her Fat Friend, weren't you?
Well, so much for frankness.
Fat Friends was really good because it was a brand new show, so we were kind of the OGs, and it was like, if there was another cast that would come in, it would be moulded around
us.
Yeah. So
that's a big fucking mould.
I'm relentless.
I really help you out here, don't I?
You twit.
You've got a beautiful family, you've got three kids.
Yeah.
One of your kids is autistic and he has to wear...
ear defenders.
Yeah. Is he making that up? He just doesn't want to hear you sing.
Yeah. Do you
I
know
don't
what?
Think he's autistic.
I think when he comes to watch a show, he was wearing his ear defenders and I actually said to him, do you not want to take them off so you can hear Mummy's voice? And he was like, no, thank you.
I don't think so.
To be fair, you looked out and half the audience had them on, didn't they?
Hey, Max, great show.
Cover your ears!
You are, honestly, a down-to-earth, lovely, lovely lady.
Thanks, mate.
You've got my number.
certainly got yours.
I hope it continues for you, because you're like the Emperor's clothing, aren't you?
The king is in the all together, but all together, the all together.
Do you know what I do at the end of my interviews?
Punch me in the face?
No, you should have done that to me. Have a little selfie.
Do we? Should we have one?
On my bed. Can we have a selfie?
Yeah,
on my
have
bed?
You got your phone?
Yes, of course I've got my phone, Mum.
There you go.
Look at us looking beautiful. So we have to look God. There. You are a bit rubbish at looking.
I look at myself. I don't know. I can't help it.
I don't know why. Right, here we go.
Yeah. Do you not want to take them off so you can hear Mummy's voice? And he was like, no, thank you.
Here we go. That was fun, wasn't it?
Yeah.
You said it. Right, this is my comedy slot section.
Okay.
Yeah. Now, were you a yellow coat or something like that?
I was a blue coat.
Blue coat, there you are. Bit of blue for the dads. Mm-hmm. Well, what this is, I think she's the yellow coat. Did you have to entertain the camper? Oh, poor campers. Mm. I said it. And this one is her singing. And what's happened here, I'm going to put this up here. What's happened here is I believe she's seen something. Someone's shown their boobs or a downstairs region on a fella.
Okay.
And she started laughing through this song.
Mm-hmm.
And you're a singer, aren't you?
I love
sometimes.
Yeah.
And it goes higher and higher because of that laughing thing.
Okay.
So it's self-explanatory.
Okay.
I don't really have to give it a commentary.
I'm not wearing a tenor lady, so.
Should have done. She said it. So here we go. There you go. So look, she's singing. I think somebody's standing here, the boobs, showed the boobs. Look at, really can't help herself. She's going, no, I'm back on track now. Yeah, it's good. You've got it.
The laugh!
And just can't get it out. Look at the band people, just turned away from her because they can't bear it. Look at, start again. Right, we're going to start again. I'm on track now, it's fine, I've got this.
I'm just looking at her mic control as well, I'm like...
Yeah, mic control, not take it away when you're laughing. And she's almost like singing into a paintbrush, I think. Here we go, look. Here we go. I love it. What about not moving the mic? I'll keep it right there. And here we go. Look, here we go. I'm back. And no, I've got it back now. And. There she goes. I beg your pardon. Where's she gone? Oh, I know. I'll give her something that she'll give me three yeses for. I said it.
It's all you have to do.
Oi, Bailey!
Fucking hell!
Oh, no. This is one of those Timmy Toilet shows.
I did it through.
Well, I used to be a prison officer, and you need banging up for this performance.
I know someday now they'll see your colours too. Cause I know in time you see why.
Silly bitch.
And you'll come running back. I'm gonna rain on your parade.
Sorry, it's a no from me, Timmy.
Yeah, and I'll keep raining.
Watching this shite, I've got to be Mrs. Potts in Beauty and the Beast.
And I keep raining up in you.
You said it.
Sam Bailey!
So if you want to hear all her tales while she was on that show, what X Factor that she was in and was doing...
Oh, I would have liked that one.
Should have done. I'll do it again.